We're given the cost function C of x and the demand function P of x. We want to find the production level that will maximize profit. Since profit is equal to revenue minus cost, let's begin by determining the revenue function. Where the revenue function R of x is equal to the price per unit, which is P of x, or P, times the quantity of items produced and sold, which is x. But we know P, or P of x, equals 1,500, so the revenue function is 1,500 times x. And we're also given the cost function C of x, which means our profit function P of x would be equal to R of x, or 1,500x, minus C of x of the cost function. So we'd have minus the quantity 2,600 plus 500x plus 0.9x squared. And now we'll clear the parentheses and combine like terms. So if it's helpful, because of the subtraction here, we can think of distributing a negative 1. So we'd have P of x equals 1,500x minus 2,600 minus 500x and then minus 0.9x squared. So combining like terms, our profit function P of x is equal to negative 0.9x squared. Combining the x terms, we'd have plus 1,000x minus 2,600. Now that we have the profit function, we can determine the production level, or the value of x, that will maximize the profit. The first step is to find the critical numbers of the profit function. And we can do this one of two ways. One way is to determine where the first derivative is equal to zero or undefined. The second method would be to determine when the marginal revenue and the marginal cost are equal. Let's determine where the first derivative is equal to zero or undefined. So P prime of x is equal to the derivative of negative 0.9x squared. So we multiply by 2, that's negative 1.8. Subtract 1 from the exponent, that would be x to the first, or just x, plus the derivative of 1,000x, which is 1,000, minus the derivative of 2,600, which is 0. Notice how the derivative function is linear, which is never undefined. So to find the critical number, we'll set this equal to 0 and solve for x. So subtracting 1,000 on both sides, we have negative 1.8x equals negative 1,000. And now we'll divide both sides by negative 1.8. We have approximately 555.56. So we only have one critical number, but we still should verify this value of x will maximize the profit, not minimize the profit. We probably recognize that the profit function is a quadratic where the leading coefficient is negative, so we have a parabola that opens down, and therefore the profit function is always concave down, verifying at this x value we would have a maximum. But the other option would be to use either the first or second derivative test to determine whether we have a max or min at this x value. Notice if we found the second derivative function, P double prime of x, it would be equal to just negative 1.8, which again means the function is always concave down, or in this shape here, and therefore at this critical number here we would have a high point or a maximum function value. But because x represents the quantity produced and sold, we should round this to the nearest whole number, so we'll round this to 556. So we can say the profit will be maximized at a production level of 556 units. I hope you found this helpful.